Ah, hello, and welcome to another edition of Behind the Lens Video Style. It's game day. Yep. Week 5, game 5, yours truly right here at Ray Hughes Stadium. Got a big one tonight, kids. Got a little Rotsy or something going on over here. We're doing bear crawls or something. Let's get on with it. We got things to do. Blaze Duo, Armstrong, Dowdy, Scary for Oakland. Front page right there with yours truly, Tom Crager, DNJ. Crager's Corner. Council pursues next city's attorney. And there he is, the man that makes this high school work in the background, John Jones. Big supporter of Oakland Athletics. I mean, we're carrying tires and doing all kinds of stuff. I wish I could had a 360 camera here, at least you could see what's going on. Showdown! There he is, Jacoby Stevens and Miller Armstrong. Blaze two-headed monster offense challenges Oakland. Tom Crager. Maybe I know if Blaze will beat Pats. Tom Crager. Floyd Stadium should be filled. Aldo Amato. The picks, and there they all are. Got Jones and Dubin and Sparks and Crager and Poe, Aldo and Taylor Wright. Jones now shares lead with Dubin. Jones is 23-7 on the picks, and so is Joe Dubin. Well, Crager said he was busting it up. He's 22-8. I don't know. Let's find a topic. Tom, where's my little capsule? You didn't, normally you get that. Let's get that down first before we get to our topic. So right here tonight, Oakland and Blackman. And then you got Cookeville at Siegelville, Riverdale at Coffee County, Warren County at Smyrna, Shelbyville at Laverne, Stewart's Creek at Columbia, Eagleville at Cascade, Clay County at MTCS, and York Institute at Cannon County. York. Cookeville at Siegel, Riverdale at Coffee County. All right, loyalty. Tom wanted me to talk about loyalty. Here's a good example. See all this data here that Tom and his team has to put out? Loyalty. What if that wasn't there? What if Tom didn't care? What if Tom didn't follow through? You know, being loyal, it takes time to develop loyalty. You know, it's not something you just snap out. It's an intangible to start with. Whether you're loyal to your team, and we've talked about being loyal before, but you know, Tom, I think it's a broken world, and it's been that way since the day the earth was created, if you get where I'm going. And I'm not, I'm by no means a pastor, but you know, I mean, that's the way it is. I mean, and I think there's lesser value. I will agree. I think this generation probably needs to take a step back and get and become a little more loyal. Maybe they need a little shakeup, a little something to make them more loyal. I'm not saying a big cast out of a war or something like that. What happened in World War II, where you know a whole all 50 states joined in and became loyal and said, you know, we ain't gonna let this ship go down. You know, there is a lot of flip flop going on, and I see it with today's generation, and I don't really have an answer. But kids, I will tell you this, you know, whether it's your job or your wife or whatever, the only way you get it is through time and you know, sacrificing, doing something that, you know, always doing the right thing, you know, being loyal, whether it's to your company or whatever. In my case, I would say being loyal is, I'll always probably work, if I work in wireless, I'll probably always work for the company I'm working for. I wear their colors strong. Their colors are black and gold, and everybody knows it. They're headquartered out of Pittsburgh. I love them, and I'll do anything for them. You know, and they know it. I don't have to tell them. You know, sometimes you don't even have to tell somebody you're loyal about something or that you are faithful to something. You show it with your actions. So maybe that's it, Tom. It's not something you say. Loyalty is something you do. Am I not right? It's a practice. Let's think about that. Be loyal to your team tonight. Be loyal to everything. And some things you'll have to sacrifice, and you won't be able to be as loyal as you'd like to be. And you'll figure that out as you go along. In other words, you may not have all the material you need to be as loyal as you'd like to be.
Well, winding down. Winding down.
Let's find another topic to put the paper.
Ooh, Tom, fly away.
Let me get that back together. Oh, that was like that. All right, going on, whether we got the everything we need or whatever, there's gonna come time in life where we gotta go on. We gotta pull the trigger. The boat's gotta leave the dock. We've got to do whatever it is we gotta do. And it's whether we've got all the ingredients or not, we're gonna make it work. And sometimes that's what it is. It's make it work. You know, go with what you got and let it happen. In other words, you may go to the Kentucky game tomorrow, to the Tennessee game, or whatever it may be. We may leave the favorite hat at home, and you may say, "Oh gosh, I can't go to the game because I don't have my favorite hat." Go on. But it'll become much more serious in the game of life as you move on, kids. Like a situation came last Friday night. Miller Armstrong got the breath knocked out of him, landed on the ball a little bit wrong, and that happens. I mean, if you're playing high-tense and high-tempo game and going at it 110%, you're probably going to get a little dinged up. We expect that. And the backup quarterback had to come in. At that point, they never missed a click. They went on. And sometimes you don't have all the ingredients. You know what you do? You put it all together and you go on. You go on. It may not be the best thing in the world, but you'll remember those times more so of when you had less and went on and struggled through it versus if you had everything. Think about it. Think of all the things that you've done where, remember when we didn't have a hammer and we just took a rock and we built that house? We went on. So tonight, you know, you may be stuck with it. It may be in a couple of weeks. Maybe over at the Coffee County Riverdale game, that somebody is left with something and they got to go on. They got to finish the game. It's going to happen. Well, tonight, Judy and Al will be here. We've had a great, great week. Talked to the chief yesterday. We talked a little bit about what's going on. We only got a few. We're winding up the quarter. So we're getting ready to head into our last quarter of the year of sales, and I'm excited about that. Got a little traveling due in October. Logistics are going to get a little crazy. You know, you kids will be missing one lens, but you're going to make it. I got to go out of town. I got to do a convention, and I need to meet with Mr. Nisik on Friday morning of one of those lenses. But hey, I do want to say something to a person, a special young lady, Lil Spence, my daughter. She's wanted to make the lens ever since the lens has been going, and now you've made it. She made a decision last week to start playing soccer just out of the blue. Our school needed her, and she's up at Oneida Baptist Institute in Kentucky, home of the Mountaineers. And they play a little soccer, and she's now playing soccer. And hey, love it. You know, you're getting involved. You're staying loyal to your school, and you're going on even though you may not have everything you need. You know, you're making it work. You may not be the best soccer player in the world, and it may be new to you, but you're learning, and that's what I love most of all. Well, so kids, I'll see you tonight. God bless. Take care. I'm a man who truly, truly delivers. Enjoy all the people saying thank you and coming up to me at the games and appreciate the interviews. We're really hot right now, and I appreciate you. None of this is possible without you. You guys make it all fun. So, appreciate all the likes and the tags and tweets and posts and all that stuff. You know, only 5 more weeks of this stuff, and then we'll move into playoffs, and I'll get off this field, and we'll let some kids, and we'll let them really grow up and let them learn, because somebody's going to put their helmet up. That's what it's going to be about. But anyway, I'll see you tonight, 7 o'clock, right here at Ray Hughes Stadium. Oakland and Blackman. Boys and kids, it's going to be a great game. I'll see you tonight. How about Tom? Hey, did you notice here? I put a little scotch tape on Tom. He took a hit. Judy threw him off the press box the other night at Blackman. I don't know if I caught him wrong or something, but he's got a little, I think he looks better. Don't you? Look at him. See you tonight, Tom. We'll be tag teaming some interviews tonight, folks. Watch for the clips.